Hey ladies and gentlemen, Steven here from Rattle Essence and welcome back to another video. I hope this video finds you well. And in today's episode, we're going to be taking a closer look at a fragrance by the company Giorgio Armani. And this one is called Si Fiori. So make sure to stay tuned. So this fragrance was released in 2019, and of course this is a flanker of the original C. Now they have come out with a few flankers, and every time they do, I always pay a visit to my local Macy's and I try to get my nose on it just to see what the variation or what the distinction is from that one to the one before it. And I find that a lot of them do have some unifying notes in there. So we have seen vanilla carried along. We've also seen blackcurrant make a few different appearances. And of course, some of the other ingredients also include like neroli, rose. There's also a little bit of like this musky thing going on in the base. Now the perfumer is Julie Moss, and she also works over at Mon. She has made fragrances for Shea in London, also about a dozen or so for Giorgio Armani, if not more, could be more now. She's also made fragrances for L'Occitane as well as Lalique. And so she's a pretty well-established perfumer, and I'm really excited to be reviewing this one. But let's go ahead and start things off by taking a very quick and close look at the presentation. So the box for this fragrance is rather simple and similar to its predecessors. Just says C right in the middle there, and then Fiori, which is the name of the flanker. And this is Eau de Parfum concentration, and I opted to purchase the 50 ml size. On the bottom of the box, you don't have a UPC, but you do have the serial number punched in there towards the top if you're looking to authenticate your purchase. And the UPC may be located on the back of the box along with the ingredients. The top of the box just has the Giorgio Armani logo. And in terms of the bottle, it is opaque, so you will have a hard time seeing how much liquid is left in your bottle because it is colored from the inside, but it has an aesthetic and presentation that is rather similar to other fragrances within the C line. On the bottom of the bottle, you will see the sticker with the serial number printed in white ink if you're looking to authenticate your purchase. The cap for this fragrance does click into place very securely. You can pick it up from the cap, and the distribution on the atomizer is very wide. Let's continue with the smell. Now, as soon as this fragrance opens up, you are going to get this velvety creaminess that I think is coming from the vanilla. Now, the vanilla that's used in here is not sickeningly sweet. It's not tooth decayingly sweet. And I would hesitate to call this a gourmand. I don't think it has many gourmand tendencies. And I think that that's because the formula is balanced out by some other ingredients. Some of these ingredients happen to be of a citrusy nature. Some happen to be of a floral nature. So I definitely do get a lot of rose in this one. But the rose that's utilized here is not as strong as the rose that you would find in some other fragrances like Portrait of a Lady by Frederick Malle, or even some designer variants like Cartier Dunsoir. And so with this one, I find that there's a certain tartness that plays hand in hand with the vanilla. And I seem to enjoy that tartness very much, as a matter of fact. So that tartness is inevitably coming from the blackcurrant. And the blackcurrant note, it's interesting because whenever you think of blackcurrant, you think of, okay, it's going to be this fruity note, and it's perhaps going to be fruity and perhaps a little bit sweet leaning. But when I've smelled blackcurrant in its original form, or in its pure form, I should say, kind of has this musty and musky vibe about it. And I can see how that shapes the identity of this fragrance, but not in a repulsive way. And so I don't mean to turn people off. I do think that it's included in a really nice way, and obviously it's blended very well by the perfumer, but I can see how it has this underpinning to the composition that really gives it depth and character. Now in the base, you're also going to pick up on some musky components on account of, I believe, a synthetic musk that's utilized in here. And then that sweetness seems to linger because if you don't know, vanilla or vanillin, as is probably the case with this fragrance, is going to stick around for quite a bit. And it's one of these synthetic ingredients that has a larger molecular structure, and so it's often used as a fixative in the perfume. And I like the way that it's done in here. I really have to be honest, this is a really nice, sensual, feminine fragrance. And for those of you who don't know, they wanted to pay a nod to modern femininity. And that's kind of what the C line is about. And I do think that C Fiori kind of takes it in that direction, adds a tiny little bit of citrus in the opening, puts that rose note in the background, amplifies the vanilla, and allows it to share the stage with the black currant, which kind of makes things a little musky, but not overwhelmingly so. So I've smelled some really musky perfumes out there, and I have a hard time saying that this one is overly musky, but I like the balance, and I enjoy and appreciate the dichotomy. I do think that this is also an aroma or a smell that will resonate with a lot of people. And so given the history of the Armani line, I mean, I've owned many Armani fragrances, some for men, some for women, of course, but I think this one has this mass appeal component about it that will resonate with a lot of consumers. And so I don't think anything about it is overly youthful. I don't think anything about it is overly mature. I think this is kind of like a middle of the road, nice balance between the two, thus amplifying or increasing the fragrance's versatility and the wearability. Many occasions, many different seasons as well, although floral ingredients kind of put me in the mindset of spring, but I do think that there's something about this fragrance that can be worn all year round and for a variety of different seasons as well. And obviously, I'll share a little bit more detail and insight about that later on in the review. But overall, if you're looking for something that's a little bit sweet, but not angel sweet, if you're looking for something that's a little bit rosy, but not alien, floral, I know Alien has the jasmine in there, but you know, in terms of the concentration of the floral ingredients, it's not as strong as some other fragrances out there, but you're looking for something that has a nice balance of sweet and sultry, almost kind of like a black orchid, or maybe like an black opium by Yves Saint Laurent, where kind of shares the stage between the florals and the coffee, and black opium kind of having this truffle note, but also being a little bit floral as well, having that unique accent, I really think sets the fragrance apart. And I do think that this one manages to do that in a way that's not overly quirky. Let's go ahead and finish things off with my overall assessment. So first up, in terms of the uniqueness and the overall smell, I do appreciate and admire the fact that this is a unique fragrance, however, bearing resemblance to its predecessors, thus making it a true flanker. Because I think a lot of flankers out there smell nothing like the original fragrance, but the company is using it as a means to capitalize on the name and the presentation, and in the interest of simplicity, and so they don't have to put in that extra work creating a new bottle, you know, and creating a new design. And that doesn't seem to be the case here. I like how they're mildly altering the formula, and it's something that I can appreciate and be a part of. Now, in terms of the overall smell, I do think it will resonate with a lot of people, and it does lean a little bit into feminine territory, but I do think that it's modernly feminine, and I do think that there's a sensual component to it as well. I would love to smell something like this on my wife. Too bad she doesn't really like this one. In terms of the longevity on this one, I got about 6 hours, which is average, especially given the concentration. The projection for this one was pretty good. It jumped up off my skin for 2 to 2.5 hours, and it really wasn't until that 4.5 to 5 hour mark that it sat really close to the skin and ended up becoming a sensual sort of skin scent, right? Kind of reserved or contained within your small bubble. And so if you're looking for something that is really loud and rambunctious and something that will make heads turn, perhaps this isn't that scent. It does sit a little bit closer, and so it doesn't really radiate beyond an arm's length, but it will get you noticed if somebody is within your immediate bubble there. In terms of the versatility for this one, I do find it to be rather versatile, as I stated earlier on in the review. I know it's marketed for women, but if you're a fan of these types of fragrances, obviously these are just recommendations. Wear what you like, wear what makes you happy. For this one scent in particular, however, I do think that the inclusion of the floral ingredients will make it feminine leaning, but I think the vanilla and the black currant will kind of help it escape from that designation somewhat. I think that whenever I think of florals, I think of spring. In the case of this fragrance, however, having a nice balance of all those different ingredients, you can wear it any time of the year. And I think this one can be worn dressed up as well as dressed down. It's not overly simple that it makes it casual, but it's not overly complex that it makes it unwearable. And so it's a really nice balance of the two. And in terms of the presentation, I like the look of the bottle. I like the black cap. I like that contrast there. So my final verdict on this one is, if you're in the market for a fragrance that smells floral, but not completely floral, if you like notes like vanilla and some other sweet ingredients, and you're looking for something that's a little bit on the sensual, musky side, definitely check this one out. You know, I think that this is a fragrance that you will enjoy. This is one that I personally really enjoy, and I actually enjoyed wearing this one as I was testing it. Obviously, it's not my style. I go for something a little bit heavier, something a little bit more challenging and experimental, while still being wearable, of course, not something too overt or too out there. But I actually really enjoyed wearing this one while I was wearing it during my testing phase. So thank you so much for tuning in. That was my review of Si Fiori by Giorgio Armani. If you do have experience with this fragrance, I would love to know what you think. Go ahead and leave a comment down below. Also, please don't forget to subscribe to this channel if you are new to this channel and you took something of value from this video. Subscribing is easy. All you got to do is click that red button in the corner. And this way, whenever I do upload future fragrance related content, it will get delivered straight to your feed and you'll be notified about it. This way, you never miss any of my future uploads, including but not limited to fragrance reviews just like this, top 10 videos, giveaways, unboxings, and a whole lot more. Thanks again for watching. I love you all, and we'll see you soon. Bye.